Hi, welcome to Smeester's Corner. My name is Adam Smeester. Today we're going to be talking about habits and how your habits shape you. So, everything that we're going to be talking about today comes from the book Atomic Habits by James Clear. So let's get started. When it comes to habits, a lot of people think that you have a goal and then your habits help you meet the goal, which is true. Some people don't even think about their habits and how their habits are going to help them meet the goal. They haven't even thought about the habit part. They just have the goal. But we have to separate the two. So there are goals and then there are systems or habits that help you reach the goal. If you don't have good systems or habits, you won't rise to meet the goal, or maybe your goal isn't as lofty as it could be. So maybe you know you kind of have bad habits, so you set your goals kind of low. Your goals are dependent on your habits. So if you don't have good working habits, you won't rise to meet your goals. So like maybe say your goal is to pass the class, get a better grade on the quiz or the test. Your goal is dependent on your habits at school and at home. So I have a lot of kids that come in at the very beginning of the year and they want to do better, and they've decided they're going to do better than they did last year, but they just have a goal. And maybe they change their habits at school a little bit. So maybe they decide not to be on their phone as much. Maybe they decide to actually pay attention in class and just do the work in class instead of blowing it off or trying to sleep. But their habits at home are completely the same. Those kids, they do better at first, but they tend to fall back into their habits and they tend to not meet those goals because they haven't changed their habits at home and at school. So people and students tend to not rise to meet their goal as much as they tend to fall into their habits, which means it doesn't matter how lofty your goal is, you will always fall back into your habits. So if your habits are good, you will tend to fall back into those habits and you'll find success. If your habits are bad, you will tend to fall back into your habits and you won't find success, even if you have a good goal. The outcomes in your life are a lagging measure of your habits. So for example, your bank account is a lagging measure of your financial habits, how much you decide to spend, how much you decide to save. Your fitness is a lagging measure of your eating and exercise habits. Your organizational behavior is a lagging measure of your cleanliness and your clutter habits. So if you have a lot of clutter, if you live in clutter, if you're a cluttered person, you will have a cluttered mind. If you have a cluttered mind, that will lead to stress and you will always be running late and things like that. This brings us to our next point. Your environment will help shape your habits, or shapes your habits. So take a look at your environment. Are you meeting your goals? Well, what's your environment like? Do you have a TV in your room? You probably end up watching that thing more than you should. Do you have a cluttered room? Do you watch TV before you do your homework? What's your phone habit like? How often are you on your phone? Do you do your homework with your phone directly by your side on the desk or on the table or on the bed or wherever it is you do your homework? Studies have shown that if you're trying to be productive and you have your phone out there sitting, your IQ drops about 10 to 12 points because your brain is subconsciously also going to be focused on the phone and what's happening on your phone. That's a big deal. 12 to 10 points, that's a lot. So if you're frustrated because you're not reaching your goals at school or in whatever productivity that you're trying to do, well, look at your phone habits. So there are bad habits and there are good habits. And here's the difference. Bad habits have a good short-term outcome and a bad long-term outcome. So the good short-term outcome might be like if you smoke, you immediately get that kick, you feel better, but the bad long-term outcome is that you might get cancer, all right? If you're on your phone a lot, yeah, you have a good short-term outcome because it makes you feel better, maybe you're relaxed, maybe you watch TV and Netflix all the time, but the long-term outcome is you perform poorly on whatever it is you're doing. It's tough to focus sometimes, which you don't think it is, but in your brain, you're not focusing like you could be. Maybe you don't do well on the test. Good habits have a bad short-term outcome and a good long-term outcome. For example, going to the gym. That's a bad short-term outcome because you feel terrible when you're going to the gym because you're out of breath or your muscles are burning the whole time or whatever it is. You feel uncomfortable. But it's a good long-term outcome. Okay, so putting your phone away. Bad short-term outcome because maybe you're not connecting with friends the way you want to be. You may be missing some things. But good long-term outcome because you get whatever it is done that you need to get done. If you don't know if your habits are good or bad, just look at your mental state. That could be one indication. How's your mental state? Are you constantly stressed out? If you constantly feel stressed out or anxious, look at your phone habits. That's probably a big determinant. So people focus on goals, which is good. You want to pass the class, you want to get a certain grade, you want to make a certain team, maybe you want to be a starter, but your habits will determine the outcome. If there is a gap between your goals and your habits will always win, always. Goals are good because goals give you direction. They tell you where you need to go, what you need to do maybe, but it's your habits that will determine the success of that goal. So here's the last point, think about this. If one of your goals has to do with any sort of competition where you're competing against other people and it's kind of a zero-sum game, either you win or you lose, your opponents also have the same goal. So having a goal is good, but what if your opponents also have the same goal? Well, who's gonna win if you have the same goal? It's the person with the best habits. If you look at the most successful people in competition, Michael Jordan, LeBron James, Jerry Rice, J.J. Watt, those guys have better habits than all the other guys do. Like Steph Curry, he's not particularly more athletic than all the other guys are, but his habits, the way he trains, is a lot better than all the other guys. I see a lot of students that are trying to make certain teams and they're telling me what their goals are, but then I'll ask them what they're doing on the off season or at home and they're not doing anything. They don't do anything at home. They only train as much as they need to at school with the coach and the team, but they don't do anything beyond that. Well, you might make a certain team, but you're not gonna be a standout. So make a goal, have goals, that's good. Then organize your habits to reach the goal. And if you don't know what that is, just ask yourself, would a successful person be doing this to reach the goal? You probably know the answer to that. That might require a change in lifestyle. And a lot of people don't meet their goals because they don't want to have to change their lifestyle. There's a lot of people who go to the gym who that's kind of a change in lifestyle because that's a little bit more time out of their day. But they don't want to have to change what they eat and they don't want to really work as hard in the gym. They're just doing the bare minimum. The people who are most successful at meeting their goals are the people who sacrifice the most. So if you're not sacrificing anything in your habits, you're probably not going to meet your goals. I hope this helps. Thanks for watching.